final thoughts tonight to Dick Irvin, whose dad and he have been part of this organization in one form or another since 1940. Of course, Dad is a coach, and Dick broadcasting the Canadians and providing accounts. But as always, as we conclude the year, we have special thank yous in order, and we start always with Molson. Next year, the television deal will be up, and negotiations are currently underway at the office in New York. I hope that the people who are involved in this affair will understand the Molson commitment to our game and where it's taken it in our country. As always, Molson, we wouldn't have the Canadian place number one, and we wouldn't be the export without you. To Ford and to Pepsi and to Esso for your contributions in helping us to bring the game along, to Owens Corning Fiberglass Canada for after 40 minutes during the course of the year, and to all the other sponsors who helped to put this show on the air, to our CBC crews who are here in Canada as collective units, brought the shows out of this country, and then as leaders of the pack in the U.S., as always, technical and production, a brilliant job. We want to thank all the public relations departments around the NHL and the special ticket offices, and most of all, we want to thank you. We hit over 4 million viewers in some nights. Last year, I don't think we got above 2 million, but whether it's one viewer or 10 million, you're the reason the show and the game is where it is. As I say, I'd really like to leave this this final thoughts on an amazing bit of destiny. Dick, the Montreal Canadiens win. Can you put it into words?
You think that mist that's rising here, Ron, might be a last skater on the ice by the ghosts of Marens and the great talents of the Rocket and Béliveau? It's really interesting. Let me quote from a couple of people I talked about this. Pat Burns coached here for 4 years, and I asked Pat, what about this Montreal Canadiens mystique? He said, I can't explain it, but I know this. Nothing goes wrong for long with this organization. They always rise back up. And Bobby Orr said to me one time, he said, I think a player is a better player when he puts on the uniform of the Montreal Canadiens. And that's what I keep getting back to. It's corny, I know, folks, but there is something about that uniform. You fans in Vancouver and Edmonton and Winnipeg and Calgary who show up and chant, go Habs, go. That's, to me, it's really something. And, of course, in Toronto. It really is an amazing story, with one more being added to all of this. And, you know, it's just, they're the most interesting and at times successful, obviously, team in any sport, Ron. And I think it starts at the top. They've had the luxury of some tremendous management, some great coaching, and that pays off with all the pennants.
Well, your dad coached here. Jacques Demers comes in. We only have about 30 seconds, Dick, but what a job he did do.
You know, I thought in the playoffs, first off, they're down 2 to Quebec. And in this provincial rivalry, that's a tough place to be. He got his team back up from that. He got his team up to a point after the layoffs that they were able to sustain, for the most part, the level of play they had. And they certainly built to what happened here tonight. So, yes, it's at the top, and I have to give everybody credit for that. Mind you, we talk about the ghosts, we talk about the great players. These guys out here tonight, they're not bad either. They're pretty good.
Thank you, Dick, and Bob and Harry upstairs, and Don over in the studio, and all the crew. It's been a great year. You can always tell a Canadian, he's got his hands full, one hand on the torch, one hand on the Stanley Cup. Be theirs to hold it high.